my mother's favorite daughter. She only has one, so it's easy. I was going to read from an essay called From Sweet Valley High to the Yearning, but I suddenly had fear of Chipo appearing like this and I'd lose my place mid-sentence. So I'm just going to say that for me, changing the narrative is something that brought me to writing The Yearning. And had I not changed the narrative, there wouldn't be a The Yearning. So I'm a library nerd. And when I first went to big school, it was at a convent school, and I was very excited because there was a library there. And I read all the children's books you can think of. My favorite was Pippi Longstocking because she was a megalomaniac and a liar. And she was super strong as well. So I found a book called The Color Purple when I was very young. We won't talk about how I found the book, but I didn't realize how distant my life was from the lives of the children in the books that I was reading until I read The Color Purple. So my dad used to do this thing. I'd bring library books and he'd just check them just in case I was, you know, reading something apartheid-y. And he saw The Color Purple and he was like, well, it's obviously a book about a color, right? And I sat in my room for hours and hours and hours because I could not believe this, a book about black people. I'd never read a book about black people. And that's when I realized that I was just a spectator in literature, just a spectator. I was not a voice that was represented. I wasn't even a thought. So the first time I read a book by an African author was when I was in high school. It's Nervous Conditions by Tetita Moremba. But before I got to Nervous Conditions, I'd started dealing, not drugs, although in a girls' school it was close to drugs. I was dealing smutty at Sweet Valley High fan fiction. And the best I could do with this was I didn't want Jessica and Elizabeth to be the boring girls from wherever this thing takes place. So my friend Vuyo and I started writing this fan fiction, and Jessica was from Soweto and Elizabeth was from Yeovil, because Vuyo lived in Yeovil and I lived in Soweto. And we were basically folding ourselves into shapes that we weren't meant to be folded into. We were trying our best to find ourselves in literature. So we made Jessica and Elizabeth racially ambiguous. They lived in Soweto, but their names were, you know, Jessica and Elizabeth. But it was also very sexy. I think that's the reason why our classmates liked it. It was very, very sexy. And while I was, you know, dealing in smut, I discovered Nervous Conditions. And my uncle was from Zimbabwe, so this was a huge thing for me because I didn't know you could write books about people that you could possibly be related to. I didn't think that was possible. And from The Color Purple to Sweet Valley High, Smut, to Nervous Conditions, I realized that I was writing it all wrong. And Tetita Moremba basically helped me unfold some of the folds that I had put in myself. I was bending myself into shapes that I wasn't supposed to. And Tetita freed me. And that's when I started writing honestly, because I didn't know that you could write about what you know. You could write about people like you. And it took me 10 years to write The Yearning, but for me, changing the narrative is taking it back. It's taking it back, and it is whatever the hell you want it to be. So if you want to write about a mermaid from Soweto and a werewolf from Mitchell's Plain, that's your shit, you write it. So for me, changing the narrative is taking it back. And I hope that I will never meet a high school girl who had to fold herself into different shapes so she could, you know, peddle smut, you know, under the guise of it being Sweet Valley High fan fiction. I hope that in the future, young girls and boys will have children's books about children that look like them, which is why I work, you know, I write children's books and I also work for a comic book. They say it's South Africa's first black superhero. They obviously had never seen Mopane, but. So I write for a comic book and I write children's books because I never want anyone to have the experience that I had as a little reader, because there was a lot I had to unlearn as a writer. So that's what changing the narrative means for me. Aha! I'm done. Thank you.